the Government of Uganda, through the Ministry of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, has set up a number of schemes and its projects to see that the level of poverty is reduced. One of these is the Vegetable Oil Development Project, whose objectives are increase domestic production of vegetable oil and its byproducts, raise rural incomes for smallholder farmers, and alleviate poverty.
The Vegetable Oil Development Project Phase 2 started in 2012, focused on 5 districts in Gulu Hub.
That is Gulu, Amuro, Pade, Kedgum, and Lamont. Vegetable oil development projects actually deals with 4 major oil crops, that is sunflower, soybean, sesame, and groundnut.
Phase 2 therefore concentrated on increasing the production and productivity of sunflower, but also on soybean.
So what we did was, one, training farmers in vegetable oil development, and then secondly, we distributed improved seeds.
So we bring in the foundation seeds through support from the ministry, foundation seed from Makerere, Namulonga. We give to a farmer group to manage. When they manage that foundation seed, and they see the first season, which one performed better, which one germinated fast, which one is affected by drought, which one is affected by weeds, which one is highly affected by pests and diseases.
We use a number of approaches. We use agricultural extension, where we use the farmer learning platforms as a platform for them to learn and use their own knowledge, but also at the same time, we bring in the technical know-how to guide them in how to improve on their farming practices.
After joining VODP, they linked us to IIRR, which trained us. We are very happy because through trainings, we learned new methods of planting soybean, sunflower, and other vegetable oil crops. This taught us how to commercialize these crops and reap big.
The training helped us to increase on the number of farmers who bring us seeds, for either to get oil or to get to sell the grain.
And in order for the farmers now to increase their acreages, and we realize it is actually good to work with the finance institutions, because the VSLA saving may not be enough for them to open and acquire other inputs as may be needed. So we worked with some of the bank, most especially the DFCU bank, whom have linked some of the farmer group.
VODP, together with DFCU, has supported, right now as we talk, 10 to 20 groups, and we have done over 258 million, and you find them having a lot of changes in their livelihood.
Last year, before acquiring a loan, I planted 2 acres of sunflower and I got 16 sacks from them. After selling them, I earned 960,000 shillings. This year, after acquiring a loan, I increased my acreage and I am hoping to get around 40 bags of sunflower at the end of the season.
The loan entails whereby the members always borrow, ranging from 5 million to 50 million, and it is unsecured. The borrowing is under group guarantee, give them at a prime rate. And at the current time, we are giving them at 12.5%. And the loan tenant period is up to 6 months.
Since October 2014, when we started this partnership, we've seen an increase in yields, and this is also representing higher income. Before, a farmer was earning about 200,000 shillings per season, which is about $60, and now per season they are earning about 1.5 million.
From the sunflower I planted last year, I got 15 sacks. I then contacted my trainer at the IIRR who helped me find market for it. After selling, I got 1,500,000 shillings. In 2013, I purchased 25 tons of soybean and sunflower, but in 2014, first season, I purchased 850 tons. In the second season, I got 1,500 tons. This is an indication that more farmers got involved in this project. The trainings and quality seeds supplied are working because there's an improvement in both quality and quantity.
I am so privileged to see what the farmers are actually doing for themselves. I have visited a number of farmers, both men and women, who are saying goodbye to poverty. That's the best I have ever heard from many of them.
I'm glad that the government of Uganda is teaching farmers better methods of farming in order to eradicate poverty. This has helped improve our livelihoods and standards of living. This project has improved my life as a person and my family. This can be seen through the small achievements in my life. I bought 2 oxen, which also helped me with the plowing, hence making farming easier.
I think the end of poverty on site, if we could be able to do similar works, if we could actually bring in more farmers, if you could be able to help those, you know, progressive farmers to move into more commercial farm, I think we are very close to end poverty, not only in this region, but in the entire country.